All right, let's find your way standing. We'll bring our toes and heels to touch. We've got hot 26 today. And just take a minute and roll your shoulders down and back. Let's close our eyes. And just pick up the toes and spread the toes out on the mat. Feel your feet grounded and rooted into the floor. And pull your navel in and find some length in your spine. And now just begin to notice your breath. See if you can begin to relax your jaw, your eyes, your forehead, and just finding a softness where you can. Continuing to notice your breath, continuing to relax. And I know it can feel funny just to let your arms hang by your side without fidgeting, but just let those arms relax, finding some stillness. We're going to move right into our deep pranayama breathing. So start by interlacing the fingers, glue the knuckles to the chin, elbows touch. You're standing up nice and tall, and I'm just going to talk you through this as we do it. So make sure you're not hunching over. Make sure you're standing up tall, pulling your abs in. And let's begin. Inhale, mouth closed, wind tunneling sound as you slowly stretch the arms up to the ears. Exhale, your head is back, mouth open, loud ha sound, elbows touch at the last bit of your breath. Inhale, chin is forward, wind tunneling sound, slowly stretch your arms up by your ears. Exhale, your head is back, mouth open, loud ha sound, get the palms to touch, elbows close, last bit of the breath. Inhale, chin forward, wind tunneling sound as you stretch your arms up, pull your belly in. Exhale, head back, mouth open, loud ha sound. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale, just a few more. Shoulders start to say good morning or good afternoon to you. Exhale. Inhale. Chin all the way level, stretching those arms up. Exhale, head back, no backward bending. Just drop your head back, elbows touch, last bit of the breath. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale, last three. Make these your deepest breaths yet. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Last one, inhale. Breathe in more at the top, a little bit more, 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 more. Exhale. Release your arms by your side, roll out your shoulders, and we'll come on into our half moon warm up. Inhale, sweep your arms up, interlace the fingers, index fingers point up, arms are by your ears. Inhale, stretch up tall. Exhale, take a side bend over to the right. Now I just want you to hold it there. So as you reach your arms across to the right, send your hips over to the left. See if you can roll your top right shoulder open, reach the arms over to the right, send the hips to your left, and ease yourself in here. So don't push yourself too far. This is part of our warm up, easing in here. So nice and easy does it. Few more breaths, feeling those abs work, stretching through your left side. Inhale, come on up. Exhale, soften your shoulders down. Inhale, stretch up, pull your navel in. Exhale, over to the left. And just send the hips to the right. Gently press your right foot into the mat. See if you can roll your right shoulder open. Reach and just find that sweet spot where you're staying relaxed. You can breathe deep. Soften your jaw, your eyes, your forehead. Few more breaths here. Inhale, come back up. Exhale, just drop your head back. So if you don't want a backward bend, just stay here with your head back. Or you can begin to stretch up. Exhale, dive back, look back. You're trying to reach the arms by your ears. Reaching back, looking back. And just getting to a spot that feels good. Inhale, come on up. Pull your abs in, bend your knees, fold it forward. Hands on the mat, let your head hang. Just work that out. Bend your right knee, your left knee, move your head around. And now, bend the knees as much as you need to. Glue your belly to your thighs. Reach around. Hold lightly on your heels. Work your elbows behind your calves. Glue your forehead to your knees. And then just begin to work from here as you begin to lift those legs up, the hips up. Now, this is our first round. So ease in, especially if you don't have the normal heat like we usually have. Ease in here. Just feel that good gentle stretch, your forehead as close to the knees as you can get. A few more deep breaths. If you feel a release, maybe lifting those hips up a little bit more. And now to release, interlace the fingers, index fingers point out, arms glued to the ears, rise all the way back up. Exhale, let your arms float down. Roll your shoulders if you need to, and we'll do that again. Inhale, sweep your arms up. Interlace, index fingers point up, stretch up tall. Exhale, take a side bend over to the right. Hold it there. Breathe if it feels good so you can work deeper this time. So reach the arms a little bit more to the right. Press your left foot into the mat. Send the hips to the left. Reach to the right. Take those deep breaths. Pull your abs in. There we go. Inhale, come on up. Exhale, shoulders down. Inhale, stretch up tall. Pull your abs in. Take it over to the left. Press your right foot into the mat. Send your hips to the right. Reach your arms. Roll your top shoulder open. Breathe deep. Soften where you can. That's it. Good. Couple more. Deep breaths here, reaching across, sending the hips to the right, rolling your top shoulder open. Inhale, come on up. Exhale, just drop your head back and just feel free to stay here or begin to stretch up. You start to dive back, look back. You're trying to reach your arms by your ears. Inhale, come on up. Pull your abs in, fold it forward, bend your knees, head hangs, work it out, right, left, just bend your knees, get your hips into it, feels good. And now bend the knees as much as you need to, glue your belly to your thighs, reach around, hold onto those heels, elbows behind your calves, glue your forehead to knees, and this should feel better second set. So begin to lift those hips up, and again, don't overstretch your hamstrings, just get to a good place that feels good. You can stay relaxed. If you're naturally flexible and you want to pull on your heels and draw the top of the head closer to your toes, you have that option. Good. And to release, interlace the fingers, arms to ears, pull your abs in, rise back up. Exhale, let your arms float down. Roll your shoulders. So turn back to the front. I'm going to get our music. While I get our music, we've got awkward pose. So go ahead and step your feet hip distance apart. And take your arms up parallel with your fingers together. So we've got feet hip distance, arms are up, fingers together, arms are reaching. Pull your abs in. I'm going to turn to the side. Start to sit back. Behind you, shift a little weight into your heels, reach through your arms, and maybe just find a little gentle scoop of the tailbone. So I'm wiggling my toes, I feel those glutes working, you feel your thighs, And then soften through your jaw, your eyes, your forehead. And just keep with those deep breaths. Shoulders down. And we're firing up those legs a little bit. Good. From here, stand all the way up. I'm going to turn back to the, I'll stay to the side here. So lift up on your tippy toes. We're going to challenge our balance. Start to bend the knees. Shoulders stay over your hips. Ooh. So you could just go down a little bit. On this one, don't let your hips go past your knees. Lift your heels as high as you can. Pull your abs in. Find that balance, building strength in our feet and ankles, our legs. Come all the way back up to the top. Lift the heels as high as you can. Lower your heels down. I'm going to turn back to the front on this one. Don't drop your arms. Turn your toes in a little bit. Your knees touch. So bend your knees. Get your knees to touch. Heels are slightly lifted. Not high, just a little bit. Now I'm going to turn back to the side. So keeping shoulders over hips. You could just bend a little bit and stay here. Or you can come all the way down. Testing our balance. And now let's just bounce our hips a few times, testing that balance a little bit more. Stop on the upswing, hold it here. And now very slowly come all the way back up and release your arms, toes, and heels touch. Nice work. Pick a spot on the wall in front, focus your eyes to it. We're coming into eagle pose. Inhale, reach your arms up. Exhale, right arm goes under left, twisting like two ropes. See if you can get your palms to touch. So that's right under left. Bend your knees deep, right leg lifts up high and crosses over the left leg. Now see if you can keep your knees and elbows in one line down the middle. Start to squeeze your legs, squeeze your arms. Pull your navel in and see if you can work your shoulders back over your hips. I'm gonna turn this way. Just so you can see it from the side. Squeezing arms, squeezing legs. You really want to load up that left leg, getting that into the joint there on the left side, building that strength and bone mass. Good for our bones and joints to load them up. To release, toes and heels touch, sweep your arms up. Exhale, left arm goes under right, twisting like two ropes. Draw your elbows down, bend your knees deep. Lift your left leg up high, wrap it around the right. Squeeze your legs, squeeze your arms. Sometimes the knees want to twist to the side. See if you can draw everything back in. And it's okay if your foot doesn't wrap behind your calf. You can just hold it out to the side. Actively squeezing arms, squeezing legs. Shoulders over hips. Relax and breathe deep. Good. Let's release toes and heels touch. Sweep your arms up. Exhale, arms float down. Standing head to knee pose. Shift weight into your left foot. Lift your right foot off the mat until your thigh is parallel. Focus your eyes. Hold it there. I'm going to turn the music up a touch. Hold it there. Take your deep breaths. There we go. Now, you can stay here or pull your abs in as you round down. Interlace the fingers below your toes. I'm going to turn to the side here, too. It's good to get that side view. I know it's hard on camera. See if you can get your standing legs straight. You could start to kick your heel forward. You could stay here or start to bend the elbows towards the calf. Forehead could go to your knee. And if you fall out, just get right back to it. Your way back to start. Right thigh lifted, standing tall, and Let's release toes and heels touch. Shift weight into your right foot. Lift your left thigh. Pull your abs in. Stand up tall. Focus your eyes. Hang here or interlace the fingers below your toes. I normally don't talk and do this sequence. It's definitely a lot different talking and doing it. Whew. So you can stay here or kick your heel forward. If you're kicked out, start to bend those elbows. Get your standing leg straight. Start to gaze to your knee. Forehead could touch. Find your way back to start. Release toes and heels touch. I'm going to turn to the side. Shift weight into that left foot. So you're just going to take your right arm out to the side. Shift weight into your left foot. Pick up your right foot with an inside grip. Get your knees to touch. Hips are square. Left arm comes up. Start to come forward. Pull the foot to the back. Reach your left arm forward. See if you can kick the foot into the hand like you're trying to straighten your leg. Gaze out past your fingertips. You're tightening up the reaching and pulling. Pull the foot away. Reach your arm forward. That's it. Come back to start and release toes and heels touch. So right arm goes up. Your left arm just goes out to the side. You'll pick up your left foot, inside grip. Knees touch, hips square. Start to pull the foot to the back. Reach your arm forward. Roll your left hip down. Kick the foot into the hand to take it deeper. Gaze past your fingertips. Few more deep breaths. Find your way back to start. Release toes and heels touch. We're going to do that again. Left arm comes up. Shift weight into your left foot. Pick up your right foot. Knees touch. Hips square. Start to come forward. Pull the foot to the back. Reach your left arm forward. Couple more deep breaths. Keep kicking the foot away. Reach through your arm. Come back up. And release. Right arm up. Left arm to the side. Pick up your foot. Knees touch. Hips square. Start to come forward. Pull the foot to the mat. Reach your arm forward. Roll your head down. Gaze out past your fingertips. Tighten up your reaching and pulling. Ooh. It feels good to teach. Even if I'm just teaching to a camera, I so miss it. I miss my classes. But we're all doing the best we can with what we have. Come back to start and release. Balancing stick. So come to the back of your mat. Toes and heels touch. This works everything pretty much. So sweep your arms up. Interlace your fingers. Index fingers point up. Try to keep arms to your ears. That's the hardest part. Right foot, step it forward. Arms to ears. Pull your abs in and just tip forward. Gaze about 4 feet out. Roll your left hip down. Reach your arms and legs away in opposite directions. Step back, toes and heels touch. Arms are up, left foot steps forward. Pull your abs in, try to keep arms to ears. You could just tip forward a little bit and touch down, that's okay too. Or come all the way out. So you make the yoga work for your body and how you're feeling. Make those adjustments for you. You're your best teacher. Reach your arms and leg away. A few more deep breaths. Step it back. Exhale, let your arms float down. All right, let's come back to the top of our mat. Come over to the left side of your mat. Inhale, sweep your arms up. Exhale, step out wide. So toes are turned out. Reach through your arms. Inhale, lift your heart. Exhale, fold forward. Reach for the outer edges of your feet. Halfway lift. Exhale, fold. there. Take some deep breaths. Pull on the outer edges of the feet as you draw the top of the head gently towards the mat. Don't overstretch. Bend the knees as much as you need to. Relax. All of this is within me. I have everything I need. Airplane means pull your abs and come all the way back up. Take a big step back to the left. Toes and heels touch, palms touch. Exhale, arms float down. Inhale, sweep your arms back up. Exhale, step wide on your mat. Arms are out like a T. Open up your right toes. Bend your right knee deep. Balance your hips a few times. Feels good. Releasing the hips. Hold it here. So if you're here, I just challenge you to get this right thigh as parallel to your mat as you can. Pull your abs in, reach through your arms. Turn the palms towards, I guess, me. And now tilt right arm to the inside, left arm up. So you could just tilt a little bit here. If your fingers are all the way down, let your fingers graze between big toe and second toe. And it feels good. Use this right leg. You can kind of press into your right arm and then press your right arm into your leg. That feels good. Rotate open through the chest. Gaze up if that's okay on your neck. A couple more deep breaths. Come back up to your warrior two. Let's hold it here. See if you can drop another inch. There we go. Turn the right toes in. Open up your left toes. Sink down on the left. Bounce your hips. Good. Hold it here. So I just encourage you, if you're here, take your feet a little further apart and bend deeper into your left leg. Press the outer edge of your right foot into the mat. Pull your navel in towards your spine. Turn the palms, left arm to the inside, right arm up. Fingers could graze between big toe and second toe. You're looking up towards the ceiling. Breathing deep in and press this bottom arm into your leg and press the inner thigh into your arm. Is all around us. Come back up to your warrior two. Let's turn our left toes in. Take a big step to the left. Toes and heels touch, palms touch. Exhale, arms float down. We're gonna do that one more time. Inhale, sweep up. Exhale, step wide. Open up your right toes. Bend your right knee, bounce your hips. Legs stay where they are. Turn the palms, right arm to the inside. Left arm up, take those deep breaths.
When you looked in the water and saw your reflection, the embers.
Soften through your jaw, your eyes, your forehead. Just relax with a challenge. That's what our yoga is teaching us, to use this deep breathing to stay calm through challenges.
My love is just a reminder.
Back up to your warrior two. Turn your right toes in. Open up your left toes. Sink down on the left. Bounce your hips. Good. Hold it here. Turn the palms. Left arm to the inside. Right arm up. Breathe. Relax.
First morning, sunlight at dawn, and cracks on the floor, it looks like there's a warning. Everything's changing, I'll rearrange it. So familiar, so amazing. Hopped in the car, drove through the mountains, cows in the street, club into a counting. There was the
room. Back to your warrior two. Turn your left toes in, take a big step to the left. Toes and heels touch, palms touch. Exhale, arms flow down. Inhale, stretch your arms. Let your palms touch and just cross your thumbs. Step your feet a little wider than your hips. Pick up your toes, rotate to your right. And then just twist your hips a few times. So you work your left hip forward, squaring the hips to the wall. Inhale, lift your heart. Exhale, tuck the chin, round down, bend your right knee. One hand on each side of the foot. So most important part here is forehead to your knee. So bend the right knee as much as you need to get your forehead to touch. talk forehead to knee. So I'm going to talk you through it. So with forehead to knee, press into the hands. You can stay there, or you can start to let your legs straighten. But most important part here is forehead to knee. Again, not pushing anything too far. Hips are squaring towards the mat. If you have the legs straight and forehead to knee, you can work the hands back out into prayer with fingers grazing the mat. Let's all roll it up, vertebrae by vertebrae. Turn back to the front, and then all the way to the left, twist your hips, work your right hip forward, gently square the hips, inhale, lift your heart. Exhale, tuck the chin, round down. One hand on each side of the foot, bend the knee as much as you need to, forehead to knee, and then you can start to work from there. Most important part is forehead to knee. Remember, never push too far. Squaring your hips, you have that option to reach the hands out. Fingers grazing mat. You can have a little bend in that leg. Slowly come up. Turn back to the front. Step to the left. Toes and heels touch. Exhale, arms float down. Tree pose. Let's shift weight into our left foot. Start to pick your right foot up, hold the foot from behind with your left hand, and then just gently let this knee fall back. Right hand to half prayer. So lengthen the left leg into the mat. The crown of the head lengthens up to the ceiling. So really feel that space that you create here. Pressing the foot into the floor, lengthening the crown of the head up to the ceiling. So it is okay if you stay here. You could even take regular tree pose and then just kind of touch down as you need to. Those of you that come to my Hot 26 classes, if you're familiar with toe stand, hands come to the heart and you just fold forward and then lower all the way down. Pick a spot out in front. Focus your eyes. Work your hands back. And then you just take your hands to your heart and try to balance and touch down as you need to. Release the hands, lift your hips up. If you're all the way down, a little bend in your right leg, hands to heart. And you can come into regular tree if you need to, with foot to inner thigh or inner calf. Left hand to the heart. Little bend in that right elbow. Feel some length. In yoga, we create that space in the body, and we also try to create that space between our ears, space between our thoughts as we focus on our deep breaths. Both hands can come to heart only if you want. Otherwise, stay right where you are. And you lift your right heel, sink down. Work your hands back. And then when you find that balance, hands come to your heart. To lift your hips back up, hands to heart, slowly come up. Good, release. Grab a sip of water. I'm going to grab my water. It's off camera. Towel off if you need to. Let me see how we're doing on time. We are right on. All right. Those breaths. We just need to remember. ourselves through the stressful time, anxiety and tension, that's not good for our immune system. So we just need to do everything we can to take care of ourselves and our families. So just see if you can let some of that stress melt, some of that anxiety. Just see if you can let it melt with your exhales. So as you stay with these deep breaths, start to bend your right knee in. Interlace the fingers to the shin below the knee. Use a little bicep strength to hug the right knee in towards your right shoulder. There's a slight tuck of your chin. If you need to, you can move the leg out to the side to get the ribs out of the way. And let's take our right leg long and we'll just switch sides. So hug your left knee in, just interlace and hug the knee. Breathe deep into your belly. Yoga is a science, working the body from the inside out, targeting organs and glands and muscles, ligaments, tendons, our fascia, just full body, inside out. And of course our minds, focusing on the breath, getting our moving meditation practice. Left leg goes long, take both knees in. Let's wrap the arms around the shins. For the elbows, your knees are even and together, and a lot of times the chin will be up to the ceiling. See if you can just find a gentle tuck of the chin, find some length in the back of the neck, and squeeze your legs in. Feel the tailbone drawing down, back to the shoulders draw down, and just breathe deep here. The belly moves in and out with your
left. Heels roll open, palms face out.
chin is forward. I'm just going to come up. You stay down so you can see my arms. Rock side to side. Your arms are going to be underneath you like this. So the insides of your hands will face down. You try to get your pinkies to touch. And if it feels okay, you're trying to get your elbows underneath you. If it's uncomfortable to get the elbows underneath you, just leave your arms out to the side. Your chin is forward. Straighten your right leg. Lift your right leg about 45 degrees. Soften in through the left side. And you're not only lifting the right leg, but you're lengthening it away. Like it's being pulled. Right leg lowers. Shift weight. Or don't shift weight. Keep weight out of the right leg. Just start to straighten your left leg and lift up about 45 degrees. Lengthen it like it's being pulled. Don't let it just hang there. Chin is forward. Release. Bring your mouth down onto your mat or towel. Start to press into your hands, and you'll just start to lift your feet. Maybe lift your knees. Thighs could lift. Back of the neck long. And release. Look to the right. Heels roll open. Palms face up. Relax. Let go between sets. Full locust pose. Chin is forward. Glue your legs together. Arms out like airplanes. Inhale. Lift your arms. Lift your legs. Keep your legs together. Don't hold your breath. Maybe lift your arms higher than your shoulders on this one. And release. Look to the left. Relax. We get a good release into our neck as we look each way. Second set. Chin is forward. Glue the legs together. Arms out like airplane wings. Inhale. Lift your arms. Lift your legs. See if you can lift your arms higher than your shoulders. And release. Look to the right. Relax. Favorites, bow pulling pose, chin is forward, reach back, outside grip, just below your toes, your knees are hip distance apart, inhale, start to press the feet back, lift your chest, and then roll onto your belly as you lift your thighs, this feels good, opening up the front body. Second set, chin is forward, reach back, outside grip, knees hip distance apart. Inhale, lift the feet up and back, lift your chest, you can roll onto the belly. Don't hold your breath. Release. Let's take a child's pose, hands underneath the shoulders. Start to press your hips back to your heels. Open up your knees. Walk your hands forward. And just relax down. Take some deep breaths. Soften in. Just checking on our time. Melting. Releasing. Lift it off the mat. Exhale, sit up. Grab your toes. Double exhale. Shh. Spin around. Middle of the mat for tortoise pose. So we're going to be seated here. Hips to heels. Sweep your arms up. Your palms touch. Just cross your thumbs. Try to keep your hips glued to your heels for as long as you can. Slowly start to come forward. Your forehead goes on the mat. And you're active here. So forehead is on the mat. You're reaching the fingers forward. Draw the hips to your heels. Feel active. Feel length. Nose to touch the mat. Elbows are definitely lifted. Palms and the hands stay together. And now try to keep arms to ears and hips glued to your heels. Rise back up to start. Exhale. Good job. Let your arms float down. Let's come up to our knees. Got another backward bend here for camel pose. Knees are hip distance apart. Take your hands to your low back. My fingertips face down. Draw your elbows towards each other. Real important to feel length in your spine. So lift the crown of the head up towards the ceiling and just start baby, little baby steps here. Little baby backward bend. Shift hips, gaze up. So it is okay. Stay right here if this is enough. Those of you that do take my class on a regular basis, if you want, go ahead and reach back for your heels, shift your hips forward, and let your head relax all the way back. Hands to the low back, slowly come up. Lower the hips back to your heels. So we've got rabbit pose. We're going to take a forward bend now to release the spine. So reach back for your heels. You won't be able to get a good grip until you come forward. Lift your heart. Exhale, tuck your chin. Now, I'm not going to do this quite yet because I can't talk into this. But as you start to round down, you'll get that grip on your heels. You're going to take your forehead as close to the knees as you can get, and you want the very top of your head on the mat. It's real important that you pull on the heels. You don't want weight in the head, very much weight in the head at all. You don't want to strain through your neck. And then you just start to lift the hips up off of your heels, weight out of your head, no strain in the neck. Your arms are straight. Legs, your glutes, pull your abs down, sit right back. you want your whole yoga practice to be in that, in that sweet spot. Slowly come up. Let's turn back to the front and take our twist. So we'll have our left leg under. This right leg crosses over. Sit up tall. Right hand behind. Make sure your right sit bone is grounded. Inhale, reach your arm up. Exhale, the elbow to the outside of the thigh. Lift up tall and start to twist. Look over your right shoulder. Some of you may want to reach for the bottom knee. You can also work the arm through the space in the leg and reach around with this right hand and hold on to the fingertips. Bring out all that tension with each exhale. Just choose to let it go. Bring it out. Release it. We think we can solve all our problems by holding on to it and thinking about them all the time, but we can't. So choose to release. Choose to let go. It feels much better. Take the gaze to the front. Unwind your legs. We'll switch it out. Cross your left leg over. Left sit bone down, left hand behind. Inhale your right arm up. Exhale the elbow to the outside of your thigh. Find that link first and then twist. Maybe reach for your bottom knee, or you can take your bind. Bring out, release, just like you would a towel. Springing out, release. With our cleansing breath. So just come to a seat here, hips to your heels. Just rest your hands on your thighs. This is a forceful exhale. And as you take the forceful exhale with your mouth open, you're just pulling your belly in. So it looks and sounds like this. Shh, 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 shh. Okay, so let's do it together. Long inhale and go. Shh, shh. Your arms overhead, just like you would first thing in the morning. Extend those legs out long on your mat. And then just find your way to your right or left side. Slowly press yourself all the way up to a seat. And we just end our class acknowledging the light within us, the light of those around us, acknowledging that we are all